It is a sight that no Western broadcaster has been allowed to see until now. I traveled across hundreds of kilometers of flat, deserted marshlands to tour one of the world's largest oil fields. Unexploded bombs from the Iran-Iraq war used to litter this area. Now, beneath this former battlefield, officials say, lies some 60 billion barrels of proven reserves.
Now, this is a massive operation covering some 900 kilometers, about the distance between, say, Los Angeles and San Francisco. They have more than 300 wells already, and that number will double by the year 2020.
Drilling on this rig in the West Qurun region is nearly complete, and crude will soon be ready to flow, adding to the global glut of cheap oil. It's not an easy job for workers. After years of sanctions, they struggle with the patchwork of old and rusty equipment. Limited access to Western technology has stunted production.
It's interesting how Iran has had to survive. This is a Chinese rig, but at the core, it's American technology, all that bit in yellow. But it was all purchased before the sanctions took hold.
China stepped into the void created by Western-led sanctions. In North Azerbaijan, the state oil company built these new facilities with its Chinese partner, CNPC.
This is the heart of the central processing facilities.
This Western-trained petroleum engineer shows off new equipment where the crude comes in before export to world markets.
This area.
It's a start, but Iran's deputy minister of petroleum says more investors are needed.
All of these need to be developed, and we need more than a few major companies to partner with and to develop these fields.
But it's fair, you need the Western technology, right?
Yes, that is correct.
While some European companies like Total of France and Italy's Eni had a presence in Iran, U.S. companies left after the revolution in 1979 and never came back. Whether major oil companies bite depends on how generous terms will be when Iran rolls out $185 billion worth of new projects at the end of November. An ambitious plan, but one which Iran is banking on to usher in a prosperous new chapter after years of sanctions have taken their toll. Growth has stalled this year, but the World Bank believes Iran could hit 6% growth with this increased production. Good for Iran, but the prospect of a flood of new supply poses a dilemma for a market flooded with oil. John Defterios, CNN, West Qurun, Iran.